Hey everyone, AngerBus27 here. Tonight we're going to be talking about an honor crimes case that took place in Houston, Texas in 2012 that resulted in a trial and conviction in 2018. Okay, so this begins in the 1970s. A man by the name of Ali Irsan, who is a native of Jordan, was raised in a Sunni Muslim family with very extremist radical views. And he travels to the United States on a student visa. Then he meets a woman named Robin Dahl in Cedar Rapids at a college there. He drags her to an alleyway, either that or a parking garage, I'm not 100% sure. And then he rapes her. Oh my God. What made Robin even more vulnerable was that she was disabled, she was blind. Sorry about that. Sadly, that was the case. He would not stop. Then he forced her to marry him or he would kill her. And they would get married. And they would have four daughters. Nasima, Nezreen, Nadia, and Nida. Ali did not let his daughters go to school, wear makeup, or do any sort of American thing. And their dress was controlled, and they had to follow their father's rules literally to the T or suffer the consequences. In 1999, the oldest daughter, Nasima, married someone who was not the right Muslim. There were two branches. They were Sunni, and this man was Shia. And Sunni Muslim is more conservative. Shia Muslim is more progressive. And Ali was raised to believe that they should only be with Sunni. And when he found out that his son-in-law was Shia, he was enraged. And he fatally shoots his son-in-law. Nasima and Robin flee. And Ali claimed it was self-defense. So he basically was getting away with it. And because of this, I blame those officers who arrived on the scene. They did sloppy police work by believing him. Totally sloppy. Then Ali got married to another woman by the name of Shmu after his divorce with Robin. And then he and Shmu would have 8 more kids. I bet he loved the movie Cheaper by the Dozen. Years later, after that, Ali had a heart attack and collapsed. But survived that heart attack. Nezreen and Nadia, his two daughters, decided to become doctors for him, which he relented and just let them go to college at Lone Star, which is basically in downtown Houston, either that or North Houston. I've been to Houston, it's a nice city, but I don't exactly know where in Houston that college is, but let me know in the comments below. The girls were definitely not expecting this. I mean, after all these years, their father said no, and all of a sudden now he's saying yes? That was not expected. And not surprisingly, they start living the American lifestyle. But Ali is not aware of this yet. And then Nezreen starts meeting two people at the college. She starts making two friends. Cody and Galloray. Galloray was from Iran and moved to Texas, and she converted from Muslim to Christian. And her family didn't mind. Cody was Christian since birth. He was raised American. And Ali would not be happy if Nezreen was influenced by Christianity. Nadia was more jealous. She wanted to, you know, have a relationship. Then she started having a crush on Cody's brother, Corey. I mean, in fact, Corey actually went there as well at the same time. Cody and Corey were twins. Corey was in love with Galray. And, you know, they were deeply in love. And then all of a sudden, Cody and Nezreen started falling in love. And after an argument between Nezreen and Nadia, Ali discovers Nesri's deception and locks her in his house, preventing her from going anywhere. Ali was livid, and he was determined to keep Nesreen locked up. And not only was he upset, but his whole family was upset. Despite all of this, Nesreen escapes, and she runs over to Cody's house. And she and Cody are finally back together again. Ali then calls the police on just to get Nesreen back home. But Ali wasn't really concerned about her welfare. He was more concerned about what he wanted. Ugh, what a bastard. Then afterwards, Nesreen convinced the officer, you know, she's an adult, she can do whatever she wanted. She was in her early 20s, which was 100% true. She was in her early 20s. And she filed a restraining order against her father. This angers Ali even more. Nesreen and Cody were finally living their happy life together. They got married and they were, you know, they were inseparable. Same, and the whole family was inseparable. I mean, Cody, Nesreen, Gallery, and Corey. Oh my God, they were so adorable together. I saw the photos of them together, and you know, I saw those photos, especially in the show, A Wedding and a Murder, and they were so cute. Unfortunately though, they were not out of the woods. They knew that Ali Irsan was searching for them. They knew that if he found them, he would kill them. And they found Galray. This is in early 2012. They pull up to Galray's apartment. She's in her car. Galray actually happened to be an activist for women's rights in Iran. And so many people thought an enemy was in the United States, but that was not true. Ali pulls out a gun, either that or his son or his wife. But as I mentioned, he did have a son in a second marriage named Nassim. One of the three pulled out a gun and then shot Galray multiple times. Galray would not survive. Then late 2012, they drive over to Cody and Nesreen's apartment. And he and Nassim break in and they shoot Cody to death. Oh my God. Nesreen comes home and finds Cody's body. She calls 911. Police at first think she was responsible. You know, it's crazy that they thought she was responsible at first. And then, you know, Ali and his family were saying false things about her. Like, she stole from the cancer center where she was working. She was trying to poison him, which was 100% not true. Then they started to believe Nesreen. And they tried to do a sting operation, but it totally backfired. Nesreen was devastated and furious all at the same time. It wouldn't take long for them to be arrested, but not for murder. They would be arrested for fraud and other white-collar crime charges. Now let's hear a word from one of our sponsors. Oh, that's right, we don't have any sponsors. Whoops. Then police would finally discover that Ali had involvement in Galray's murder. Then eventually, they found out that he was involved in Cody's murder as well. So now he was indicted on capital murder charges. And as I mentioned, in Texas, double murder is capital murder. And if you kill two people or more under the same transaction in the same episode, that qualifies as capital murder. And they sought the death penalty. Not surprisingly, Ali Irsan would be convicted and sentenced to death. I don't know how he's going to be executed, by lethal injection or by electric chair. I don't know. In the trial, his wife would testify against him, and she would be given life in prison. Along with his son, he would also be given life in prison. His daughter, Nadia, who, as I stated, went to the college with Nazreen, she got probation and was not allowed to get near Nazreen whatsoever. And now we're going to be talking about the sloppy police work of whichever law enforcement agency responded to the first case back in 1999. I can't believe that they listened to him. The officers who arrived on the scene after he shot his first son-in-law just listened to him. The fact that he was Shia was the reason why Ali shot him to death. And it's just outrageous. And he believed they should only be with Sunni. And not only that. What's crazy is that the officers didn't investigate. They should have arrested him. They should not have believed him. And now they let a murderer get away with it. He got away with first degree murder. And they should have done something in 1999. Why didn't they do it in... Why did they wait until 2012 when two others were killed? If they had arrested him in 1999, Cody Beavers and Galray Burgerzadeh would still be alive. And as a result of the sloppy police work, both are gone. And thankfully he was arrested and given and convicted and sentenced to death. But, you know, they should have done something about it back in 1999. They should have. Anyway, thanks for watching and subscribe.